An investigation is underway into a deadly Mobile County accident. Residents in the area want to improve safety on a dangerous stretch of road dubbed as Bloody 98. And local law enforcement continues to warn of a phone scam that's circulating our area. Stay tuned. Fox 10 News at 4:30 a.m. starts now.
Committed to you. Fox 10 News at 4:30.
Good morning, everyone. Thanks for choosing Fox 10 News on our Monday morning. It's November the 9th. I'm Eric Reynolds. Well, let's check in first now with meteorologist Michael White for a look at today's weather forecast. And it's still damp and misty.
It is. But it is cooler.
Cooled off, right.
It is cooled off nicely. Yeah, compared to those very hot, muggy days we were dealing with last week. That's long gone. But not really expecting to see much in the way of sunshine today. Eric, just kind of cloudy and misty. No major rain chance than that. Okay. But it does look like later this week we'll start to see the sun peeking back out. And by the end of this week, we could even be dealing with some really cold temperatures.
Ooh, right, I like that. Definitely a major difference in the low this morning compared to last week.
Absolutely. Last week, we would start off in the mid-70s, which was just awful. This morning, though, we're starting off in the 50s, which is a lot more seasonal. Here's a look at the storm tracker, the rain fading away. Now, mist and drizzle typically occur so close to the surface, the radar beam has a very difficult time picking that up. So you're not really going to be seeing that a lot on the storm tracker, but believe me, it's out there. And the sky is overcast, and that's the way it's expected to remain for most of the day. Mobile, your sky mostly cloudy. Temperature 55, a little drizzle. Pensacola, temperature 58. You got a north wind at 10. Mobile, a breezy north wind coming in at 13 miles per hour. But things have gotten a lot cooler and a lot less humid since we left you on Friday morning. Now here's a look at your weather headlines. We got a cool start out there this morning. Clouds and mist are what you're going to see. Sunshine, there's the chance we may see a peak or two of it before the day is over, but it will become a lot more abundant later this week. We will talk more about that. Still ahead in your full forecast coming up in about 10 minutes. Eric?
Thanks, Michael. Our time now, 4:32, and two people are dead and another injured after an accident in Mobile. Take a look at the scene on Moffitt Road near Meadow Lane. Alabama State Troopers say that Muriel Jones of 8 Mile and Georgia Fegan of Whistler were killed on Saturday. They say the pair died after the driver of another car slammed into their vehicle. That driver, James Mitchell of Sims, was injured. The cause of the accident is still under investigation. Moffitt Road is also known as Bloody 98 due to fatal accident after fatal accident throughout the years. Andrew Mosley has lived on the stretch of highway for 15 years. He says he's seen people crash into the tree in front of his home and his mailbox several times.
I've lost four mailboxes just because of the speed and the road is really slick after a rain like this, so they should slow down. A crash happened here along this road all the time. All the time.
A Highway 158 extension, which you see here, is supposed to help alleviate traffic on 98. But the project has stalled for 7 years due to funding problems. We're told it should pick back up in 2019. Mobile police are still working to identify a body they say was found behind a local business. Investigators say that a woman's body was found in a body of water behind the Babies R Us on Airport Boulevard. According to investigators, there were no signs of physical trauma, and they believe that she drowned. Anyone with information about this case is asked to call Mobile Police right away. A 91-year-old woman is recovering after officials say that she was injured in a house fire. It happened just before noon yesterday on the 2200 block of Dolphin Street. Firefighters say that when they arrived, the woman met them at the door. The fire apparently started in the kitchen. Crews were able to put it out before it spread. The rest of the home, however, was damaged by smoke. The woman was taken to USA Medical Center for treatment. At last check, she was listed in serious condition. No other injuries were reported. Investigators say that they believe the fire was accidental. A Mobile club owner is hoping that surveillance video will help police catch the person who tried to burn down his business this weekend. Richard Johnson says that someone deliberately started the fire at Fat Tuesday Sports Bar. That's on St. Stephen's Road around 5:30 Saturday morning. Johnson says that the suspect set a fire on one porch at the back of the building, then another fire on a second porch.
The fire didn't penetrate the building itself. However, I guess structural damage in the back.
Johnson is offering a $1,000 reward for information leading to the arrest and conviction of the suspect. If you have any information, please call Mobile Police right away. In other news this morning, we want to alert you of a phone scam happening in our area. Now, this one targeting Riviera Utilities customers in South Baldwin County. Utility company says that South Baldwin County has seen a steady climb in visitors since the 2010 Gulf oil spill and is looking now at ways to deal with the challenges. Tourism officials say that Gulf Shores and Orange Beach have seen 12.5% growth each year. To handle the crowds, 5 new hotels are going up, along with a new welcome center. There are also plans to focus on relieving traffic congestion. New ordinances will soon be in place to keep the major attraction, the beaches, free of trash.
The cities have both passed new ordinances. You'll still be allowed to have a tent on the beach as long as you stay behind landward of a demarcated line. The tents can't be over 10 by 10, just to keep, you know, down from the great big huge tents that block everybody else's view.
Tourism officials say 4.7 million people visited the area last year, pouring billions of dollars into the economy. We're just getting started here on Fox 10 News. Meteorologist Michael White will return with another look at our forecast for the week. Plus, officials in one Mississippi city don't know what caused this to happen. Take a look here. A massive sinkhole opens up in a restaurant parking lot and swallows more than a dozen cars. Our time check, 4:39, and more news coming in just 2 minutes. Thanks for watching Fox 10 News. Please stay with us. We'll be right back.
Mobile police are still looking for the suspect accused of raping a woman inside her Midtown Mobile home. Authorities say it happened last Thursday around 4 o'clock on Mohawk Street. They say the woman had just finished up yard work when a man approached her in broad daylight. They say he then forced her into her home and he raped her. She later called police from the hospital where they say a sexual assault kit was collected. Neighbors say the attack has them on high alert.
I'm out and about quite frequent because I work around here and live around here. But now my eyes be open more.
Being alert, you know, never just like walking alone no more. More like walking in groups.
Police say at the time of the incident, there was a lot of traffic and that someone could possibly have seen something. So they're working on releasing a composite of the suspect's face to the public. Family and friends gathered to say their final goodbyes to the Pritchard man who died in a fire more than a week ago. The funeral for Donnell Hunter was held on Saturday. He was affectionately known to the community as Fry Daddy after his popular restaurant. Family members say he noticed his fireworks store in flames and died trying to save his dog. Although many are still grieving his loss, they say he will be remembered for his loving spirit and contributions to the community.
He did so much. So many people love him, and he touched so many people. That's what you got to remember. It's not how long you're here, what you do while you're here. And I think he was awesome.
Donnell's family plans on starting a scholarship in his name for children here in Mobile County. They also plan on keeping his Fry Daddy's restaurant open for business hours. A forum in Pritchard gave young people a platform to speak their minds over the weekend. The Pritchard Teen Summit was held on Saturday at the William Bill Clark Center. It was hosted by Mayor Troy Ephraim. The summit serves as one of the initiatives of the My Brother's Keeper program. It focuses on equipping men of color with tools to become successful in every avenue of life. We are just getting started here on Fox 10 News. Coming up, meteorologist Michael White returns with an update on our Monday forecast. But first, more homes are destroyed as wildfires continue to burn across California. We'll have the latest when we return. And in our next half hour this morning, we are learning more about the case of a former Thomasville high school teacher who's accused of having sex with a student. Police say his arrest came after they received several tips from parents. 5:06 is our time right now on our Monday morning. Thank you for spending your morning with us right here on Fox 10 News. We will be right back right here in just 2 minutes.
You're watching Fox 10 News with Sarah Wall, Eric Reynolds, and meteorologist Michael White. Fox 10 News in high definition television.
Thanks for joining us here on Fox 10 News on our Monday morning. It's now 5:09. I'm Sarah Wall. Firefighters continue to battle raging wildfires in California this morning. Fire officials say another 162 homes have been destroyed by a wildfire that's burning north of San Francisco. So far, nearly 1,600 homes have been destroyed in two wildfires burning in that area. The fires have left five people dead. There are more than 10 large wildfires burning across California right now. More than 10,000 firefighters are on the front lines battling these fires.
And take a look at where the temperatures stand right now. We got mid-70s in the Port City and in Pensacola. Gulf Shores, you're sitting at 70 degrees. Milton and Evergreen right now, you're at 71. Lillian sitting with a temperature of 69 degrees, and the dew points have jumped up considerably from where they were on Friday. They're back at 70 plus in most spots, which means moisture content is rising, and we will see the air remaining very muggy as a result, and that's going to be the driving force for a lot of these scattered showers and storms. Now we've got some of those inland right now, and that's where they're going to be for the next several hours. Inland showers and storms possible from 6 o'clock through 9 o'clock. Temperatures will work their way up to about 77 degrees by mid-morning today, and we will continue to see some moderate to heavy rainfall with a little bit of lightning mixed in, but then by the afternoon a lot of that rain is going to leave us. We've got a stalled boundary just to our south and a surface low riding that boundary. Now when you got an area of low pressure, remember that it moves counterclockwise, so that pulls our wind in out of the Gulf, and that's going to create moisture levels rising, which is the reason why things are so muggy and humid, and it makes shower and storm formation a lot easier. And that's what we've seen over the last couple of hours. But as all of that works its way eastward, so will the rain, and we're not expecting an overwhelming chance for the remainder of the week. Now the clouds and the showers will keep our highs generally in the mid 80s today. We're going with 85 in Mobile, Citronelle 84, Theodore 86, mid 80s throughout much of Baldwin County. The forecast warm with scattered showers and storms. On the panhandle, highs will be in the upper 80s today in Okaloosa County, mid 80s around Milton and Pensacola. Century will have a high of about 84. Tonight's projected low is going to be around 64 degrees. The rain chance dropping to only 10% for the remainder of the week, but highs each afternoon will stay in the upper 80s. The lows generally most nights will remain in the mid to upper 60s. Now we'll talk more about the immediate forecast, and as always, a preview of what you can expect for Friday and your weekend. That's still ahead in the next 10 minutes. Guys.
Thanks, Michael. Time now 5:11 on our Monday morning, and coming up this week in business, new economic data will likely impact stock markets. Fox's Maria Bartiromo has more in the business week ahead.
I'm Maria Bartiromo on Sunday Morning Futures on the Fox News Channel with your look ahead to the week in business, where there is a whole host of economic data to come out, which will either convince or make markets question the Federal Reserve's move last week not to raise interest rates. One voting member, John Williams, president of the San Francisco Federal Reserve, joined me this weekend on Sunday Morning Futures. He told me the economy is improving and is ready for higher interest rates.
Much of the decline in participation since 2007 really reflects demographics, the retirement of the baby boom. And so I think that we shouldn't expect participation rates to go back to where they were in the early 2000s. There still is a gap there. If you look at the number of people who are on the sidelines waiting for the labor market to get better to start looking for work again, there are a significant number of those people. The good thing is that number has come way down, and I expect that to continue to come down through the rest of this year and into next year. My own view is we're going to see the unemployment rate fall below 5%. We're going to see improvement along all these different dimensions.
Among the more impactful reports this week likely to move markets, durable goods orders out on Tuesday, the Michigan sentiment report, and the final reading of the GDP for the second quarter out on Friday. Also this week, the president of China in the United States to meet with President Obama, the Pope on the way in the U.S. on Wednesday through the end of the week, and Monday, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu meeting with Russia's Putin to discuss Syria. I'm Maria Bartiromo. Have a great week.
A local business in the Spring Hill Village community celebrates a milestone by giving back. Carpe Diem Coffee and Tea Company turned 20 years, and to mark the occasion, the staff hosted a party in their parking lot. There were drink specials, face painting, live music, and a fun jump for the kids. Owner Alan Tolson thanks the community for the loyalty and support.
I feel incredibly honored to have such great support and loyalty with our customers. You get to know them over time. It's great to build relationships with the people that come in, and they really become a part of our lives and us, hopefully, a part of theirs.
Carpe Diem also raised money to benefit the ongoing Village of Spring Hill sidewalk project.
Shoppers will soon have another option in the Mobile area. The brand new Whole Foods store opens tomorrow. The store is located inside the Pine Brook Shopping Center on Airport Boulevard at McGregor. Whole Foods is known for offering healthy food options free of artificial ingredients. Last week, the store held tours to give shoppers an idea of what they have to look forward to.
And we're getting our first look at the trailer of a new film that was shot in Mobile.
And the stars shined at the 67th annual Primetime Emmy Awards.
We'll have a wrap of the night's big winners when Fox 10 News returns. Our time check on our Monday morning. We're currently at 5:14. More news coming your way in just 2 minutes. Thanks for watching Fox 10 News. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Time check now approaching 5:17 on our Monday morning. Thanks for watching Fox 10 News. We're getting our first look at the trailer of a new movie that was shot in Mobile. It's called Heist.
We're following the bus 657 hostage situation.
All right, boys, they get a clean shot, we take it.
Copy that.
You may recall last October, crews were in Mobile shooting the movie. At the time, it was called Bus 657. It's about a casino car dealer with a past who puts together a crew to rob a bank and hijack a city bus as collateral. It stars actors Robert De Niro, Jeffrey Dean Morgan, Mark Paul Gosselaar, Gina Carano, Morris Chestnut, and D.B. Sweeney. Heist will be released in select theaters and on demand on November 13.
The results of the weekend box office are in this morning, and Maze Runner Scorched Trails makes a solid debut in first place.
The two kids about to last one day out in the scorch.
Oh, 20th Century Fox's sequel to The Maze Runner earned just over $30 million. That's slightly below the debut of the 2014 young adult sci-fi trilogy.
I grew up with Jimmy and his brother Billy, the senator, and that is a bond that doesn't get broken.
Your brother.
Warner Brothers Black Mass, starring Johnny Depp as Boston gangster Whitey Bulger, premiered in second place with nearly $24 million. And rounding out the top five, The Visit lands in third place with $11.3 million. Coming in fourth place is the thriller The Perfect Guy with $9.7 million. And Universal's 3D mountaineering thriller Everest lands in fifth place with $7.6 million. It was a night of firsts at the 67th annual Primetime Emmy Awards. Fox's Michelle Pollino has more.